You are 19.
Yeah, I am 19, yeah.
Bringing back good memories. This is your first flip.
First flip, looking to get into it. You know, I've been reading a lot of books, and I think it's time to actually take action and learn something.
Man, I love everything about this. If I can go back to 19 with what I knew now, I would be so far ahead. So I think it's super rad that you're doing it.
Appreciate it, thank you.
So we're in Fullerton right now. How much did you pay for the house?
$430,000.
The house needs some work, I take it?
Yeah, it definitely does need some work. It's about a 4-bed, 2-bath, 1,515 square feet.
What's the rehab budget?
I think 60,000.
All right, let's check this thing out.
After you.
Oh God, that's awful.
Definitely a little smell for sure.
What do you mean little smell? It smells awful in here. Okay, so we have a cat house on our hand. Let me just take this in real quick. We have a single level.
Okay.
It's kind of dark, yeah, but it has really cool mid-century vibe to it.
Okay.
What would you do in here?
So from reading my books and just doing a bunch of studying this past year, I think laminate throughout. And then for the lighting, like you mentioned, with this kind of little dark in here, I think you do a skylight in here.
I don't think you have to do a skylight. In order to save money and make the house look better, just take down the old patio cover.
Okay.
Once the patio cover is gone, all the natural light will come in and this whole space will light up so you can save the money on the skylight.
Okay.
You're really lucky with this house because you never find a kitchen this big in this size house. So you can do some really cool stuff in here. But my question would be, what are you doing with that wall right there and what are you doing with that wall right there? And the budget you have right now, do you have any walls coming out?
It's not in the current bid.
I'd like to see this wall gone right here.
Okay.
Because it blocks the view of the living room.
Okay.
And then that way you can have an island. This wall right here, I mean, I'd love to see gone as well. The space would just be completely open when you walk in. I think that'd be beautiful. And then we have bedrooms and bathrooms. How many bathrooms is it?
So it's 2 baths.
Bathroom 1.
Planning on doing tile. And then this too, probably could do vanity right here.
How much do you have in the budget to do that?
So right now we're looking about probably $7,500, $8,000.
It's probably gonna be closer to 10.
Okay, so 10,000.
Yeah, bedroom 1. I like the big windows, brings in a lot of light. Bedroom number 2. It's not a big bedroom, but you have high ceilings. This house has cool vibes to it.
Yeah.
Huh? I feel like there's some unpermitted stuff going on. Like this whole wall was added. Just doesn't look right.
Okay.
Man, this is a good sized master. I like the high ceilings.
What I was actually thinking on putting in is actually a barn door, create a little more extra space in the bathroom.
And then the bathroom. I do not like how this bathroom is set up.
Yeah, a little awkward.
Right now it's just so cramped. When it comes to smaller houses, adding square footage most times when you're flipping is too expensive. So it's all about how do you make each space feel as big as possible? Because if we can do that, the sales price will go up.
Okay.
In the hallway, there's that pop out that I said looks unpermitted.
Okay.
I would love to see the bathroom extended. Reconfigure the whole thing. We're gonna make it bigger.
Okay.
Here's one more bedroom. So I like the layout of the house.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go to the backyard. Yeah, this house is beat up. If you were to just come in here and start this today, what would you do back here?
This gate right here, we're gonna take that out. And then obviously we're gonna resurface this pool too.
There's one other thing. It smells like weed. Do you smell that?
Yeah, I catch what you smell.
Yeah, it's very, very strong scent of marijuana. So I know it's California and it is legal, but someone is growing marijuana somewhere.
Yeah.
Have you looked over the walls at all?
I have a little bit. I did find the root of the problem too.
It's right over this wall.
Those are some big marijuana trees. Okay, so this is an entry-level family neighborhood. Whoever buys this house, most likely they're gonna have kids.
Kids, okay.
Not only like as a real estate investor, but as a father, like I wouldn't be too excited about my kids back here with those big marijuana plants. It's gonna hurt us.
I did smell the marijuana before purchasing the property with the investor. However, since it's legal in California, I thought it wouldn't be that big of a deal.
We're gonna have to figure it out. John talked to a few more contractors and the numbers came back at $85,000. So we got the investor on the line.
I think we want to get that targeted selling price of $625, $630. I think putting in $85,000 would be the right call.
And he agreed to up the budget. So now this project's ready to get going. Have you done demo before?
No.
Oh, we're gonna give you the honors. Just start breaking it.
That's no good.
The project has gotten off to a really rough start. While the guys were rerouting the plumbing to install the new beam, they found a whole bunch of corroded galvanized pipes.
We have to redo the whole house?
Yeah.
It turns out that the entire house needs a repipe, and it's gonna cost them about $4,000. You're already a little bit over budget. We need to figure out a way to get the most bang for the buck out here. I brought some paint samples, brought a shutter sample, but what are you thinking about this house? What do you wanna do?
White exterior paint on the outside. I want a cool modern look.
I like the idea of white. Mm-hmm. And just to give it a little bit of contrast, a little bit of depth, something as easy as these shutters will make a huge difference. They're super affordable.
Okay.
And then for the front door, I think a pop of color.
I'm kind of eyeing this one.
Okay, that's my favorite one, actually. Really nice.
Yeah, that makes it stand out a little bit. My main question, though, is probably the driveway. I mean, what do we think on that?
This driveway looks old. It's cracking. Mm. We have a mid-century modern house, and this driveway is about a century old.
Yeah. So even if the inside looks good, outside looks good, that driveway is going to kill it.
I think the driveway is going to kill it, man. Let's redo the driveway, but a little bit smaller. We'll save some money. On the left side, why don't we just put a bunch of black mulch? Mm. It has that mid-century modern feel. It costs almost nothing. You don't have to do irrigation, and it'll actually be a design feature.
I like that idea. I'm in. Send it. Yeah, let's do it. Let's
go. All right, buddy. Okay. All right, so I know this is not going to be a comfortable conversation, but these are the things you have to do when you're investing in real estate, when you're flipping houses. All you have to do is figure out if there's something they can do about the smell. Good luck. You got this. Come on.
Hello? Hey, how you doing, sir?
All right, how are you?
We are flipping the property right over the fence from your house,
yeah.
And we do have a little bit of a problem. That marijuana smell, and that's going to be a problem when it comes to actually selling the home.
I think I would rather live next to a guy like me than I would most other people. I mean, I'm the oldest guy in the neighborhood.
What I want to ask you is, I mean, how much longer is that going to stay there?
What I grow will be gone, but it's going to take a while.
He actually said he was going to harvest his crop soon, and that was going to be the last time he's ever going to grow. So if he's true to his word, the problem should be long gone by the time we're ready to put this house on the market.
But you still need to disclose what you know about it. That way, if something happens later, you're not liable. But that's great news. And I'm proud of you, man. You walked up to this random house in a random neighborhood talking to a guy growing marijuana in the backyard.
Yeah.
If you want to be successful at house flipping, you have to be fearless. So I am so proud of you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Wow, I love the outside.
All right, John, here it is. Your big debut, buddy.
I love the kitchen.
You were looking for like an open kitchen like this.
Yeah.
You can just tell right away if someone likes the house. It's like a first date. Within the first 20 seconds, you know if it's gonna go well or not.
It's very nice. Super open. Pretty modern. Like, I like the style. Like,
it's gorgeous.
I love this Long Island.
What do you think of the backsplash?
I like it a lot.
Yeah. Different.
Yeah, do you remember what that kitchen looked like day one?
Yeah, no, no.
I do.
Disaster zone. No,
this house made it a long way.
A bunch of light comes through, which is great.
Look at the fireplace.
Ooh. Oh, wow, the bathroom. I love it.
Oh, wow. I'm saying wow a lot, so that's good.
That's
see what they think of the master bedroom.
A lot of natural light.
Look at this door.
Yeah,
pretty
I like
cool.
That. It's really cool. Oh, wow, look how big the shower is. That's perfect for a master.
Yeah, the master bathroom just shines. If we didn't expand that bathroom, there's no way the bathroom would have looked like that.
No.
Not sure this tile is exactly my style.
The floor is pretty funky looking.
She likes it or does that?
Yeah, it's funky good.
Okay.
She likes it.
We got your sink and my sink, so I can actually get ready in the morning.
They're already claiming sinks. Come on, buy this house.
We also have a pool in the backyard as well.
Oh, wow, great size yard.
Do they smell anything?
The backyard's pretty decent. I'm not really in love with the pool.
No?
Not
really. It is a little bit small.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, though. If that backyard still smelled like a marijuana field, they'd walk out the front door and back into their cars.
I love it.
It's all well done. I wouldn't even have to change anything about it.
It's currently listed at $649,900.
Which is a steal.
For four bedrooms and a pool, we'll probably be writing an offer.
Okay, excellent.
Did he just say probably writing an offer? I like that.
Take care. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
It's always the best thing when buyers are walking in and buyers are walking out and they see each other.